All right, so with this event, whether you buy the gold dice or the regular dice, the price is pretty much the same. You're getting twice the amount of random dice, but the gold dice give 20 Gala coins per roll, and the normal dice give 10. So if your aim is to try and have more spins and landing on stuff, then maybe you want to go for the normal dice if you're trying to clear stuff. But just like perspective-wise, to get this beach barbecue, you have to get every single item on this track. That's a lot of money you're going to have to spend. My recommendation is you can spend, I think, $10 we could get away with, and we would get to this tier right here. So for 10 bucks, I think this is a good value to get 8 Alexandria fragments, these other items, getting the Titan items. But honestly, this -1 damage, like 1% damage across all troop types, that's a really good island item for 10 bucks. I think it's way better than spending 5 bucks on the other item that we looked at earlier to just increase your hospital by 1,000. So the way that I think we could do this to maximize this, there is this item here that when you land on this, you get to double the amount of Gala coins you earn. So you'd want to land on that with a gold dice because you get 20 coins per gold dice, not a normal dice. So what I think I will do to demonstrate what I think for a low spender, if you're going to spend 5 to 10 bucks, this is what I think is the way to go. So each dice, we need a total of 120 Gala points to clear these two. So that means we need 6 dice of the gold or 12 of the random, which means we gotta spend 10 bucks. It looks like it's no difference if we did the $4.99 versus the $9.99. So I'll just commit right now, do this for you. The gold dice, you get to pick the number that you're gonna roll. Well, I did the gold dice this time. Probably get the normal dice, so you'll get twice as many squares that you land on if you are not caring about which things you get specifically. What other item do I really care about along this track? There's not a lot of really great things, but let's see. If I got 5 more, if I really wanted to spend the time, I could game out where I wanted to go. For now, I'll just go get some minerals and some steel. You can see that my coins went up 70 because it doubled the 20, so it gave me 40 for that one time because I'd hit that ×2 square. Okay, and then what is this quest item here? I don't mind getting an 8-hour speed up, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4. And then the thing after it, double the amount of the next item you get. So I think I will do 4. So you can do these later. You don't have to do them immediately. That one's just 1 away. And I think I'll double trying to get this golden box there. How about that? So we'll end it with, oops, I keep clicking on the wrong thing there. I'll end it with 2 there. Okay, so we had to spend the 10 bucks to clear this wave. You can decide whether this was a good value for you. I think it's worth it because I wanted some Alexandria fragments. That would probably be around 7 or 8 bucks just to get those. And then on top of that, the biggest thing I was saying here is this Santa Claus. I mean, come on, man, have Santa Claus. But that's also just a really good thing to have a flat 1% damage reduction against all enemy troops. So that's why I made this decision. If not, you could get away with just spending 5 to clear the Alexandria stuff, and that would be good. I'm gonna go meet the incident quest here. I just gotta do some melds, so meld 10 items. Like I always say, save your material melds until you need to use them, because there's always gonna be some event going on. Come back here. I can claim that. So just to recap perspective-wise, this is a cool island thing, but it's a lot of money to get this. You'd have to clear the 32 items on this board, so if you somehow managed to perfectly land on every single one sequentially the way you needed to, which I don't even think is possible, you're going to have to buy a minimum of 32 dice. So the cheapest way you could do that is more than 30 bucks. And to be honest, I think you're more likely going to be spending closer to like 50 bucks to be able to get that single island item. Whereas if you just spend 5 bucks, you can easily clear the first tier rewards. If you spend 10 bucks, you'll clear the second. If you wanted to keep going again, like, you're going to have to spend $10 roughly for every 120 Gala coins that you want to get. So I would have to spend more than 10 bucks just to try and get this next 300 reward unlocked. So that's where you can make that decision. Like, is it really worth it to spend probably $15 to get this stuff? I don't think so. I think you can get this mini Titan Alloy and daily specials probably for a little bit cheaper. Here's a little breakdown just of what you would be spending for the different types of die and the number and quantity. So getting the first couple packs are cheaper than the other ones. Thanks for watching. Have a great Christmas.